Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome to the summer concert of the New Horizons Band Dallas in wonderful Allen, Texas. We're delighted to bring you a collection of both old and new tunes. So we've entitled our concert Something Old, Something New, Nothing Borrowed, but we got some blues. In case you're not familiar with the New Horizons Band Dallas, we are a charitable organization composed of seniors, 50 years and older, who play concerts throughout the Metroplex in senior recreation centers, retirement homes, hospitals, and wonderful venues like this. We would like to open our concert with a relatively new chart, a fanfare written by John Williams for the opening ceremonies of the 100th anniversary of the modern Olympic Games held in 1996 in Atlanta. Please enjoy listening to Summon the Heroes. Thank you very much. Now let's jump way back in time to the early decades of the 20th century. Warren Barker, an American composer who wrote many songs for film, radio, and TV, including the 1960s series Bewitched, He put together a medley of great classic old songs from an earlier era that we would like to play for you now. They include Ma, He's Making Eyes at Me, 1921, My Melancholy Baby, 1915, Ain't We Got Fun, 1937, Moonlight Bay, 1912, After You've Gone, 1918. We hope you enjoy this collection, his third in this format, entitled Themes Like Old Times, number 3.
Thank you.
you. Now, let's liven things up with a march you've probably never heard of. It was composed by Henry Fillmore for the 1930 Cincinnati Automobile Show and featured an instrument composed of 12 car horns, all tied together, all played with a keyboard. It was called a claxophone. We don't have one of those instruments with us. However, our brass and saxes will do the honors. Here is the Klaxon March. Many of the more modern tunes we know come from movies. Here are some of the great ones from the cinema that have been favorites for many decades. This medley opens with Hooray for Hollywood from the 1937 film Hollywood Hotel and contains these other classics: Singing in the Rain, Gene Kelly, 1952, Somewhere Over the Rainbow, Judy Garland, Wizard of Oz, 1939, As Time Goes By, Bogey and Bergman, Casablanca, 1942. And finally, A Day in the Life of a Fool, or Magna de Carnaval. It was made famous in the U.S. by Jack Jones and Frank Sinatra, but was originally from a 1959 Portuguese film called Orfeo Negro. You don't remember the movie, but you'll remember the tune. We hope you enjoy. Salute to the cinema.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Of course, when you think of movie music these days, you have to think of John Williams, composer of so many fantastic movie scores and recipient of 41 Oscar nominations and counting. Here is a collection of some of his best movie memories. See how many you can remember. It's called John Williams in Concert.
Thank you.
Thank you again. Now let's go old, really old, back before internet, back before TV, back before even movies. Community entertainment back then was listening to concert bands. One march that John Philip Sousa, you remember the March King, loved to play, and in fact he recorded it three times with his own band. It was written in 1893 by Joseph Wagner, not related to the opera composer Richard Wagner, to honor the coat of arms of the Austrian-Hungarian Empire. Here is his Under the Double Eagle March.
Thank you.
Well, back then, all eyes may have been on Sousa, but much of the middle and late 20th century, all eyes were on old Blue Eyes. Yeah, Frank Sinatra. With his charismatic style and polished interpretations, Frank put his unique stamp on a number of familiar standards. The medley the band features this time will be some of his best-known hits, including Come Fly With Me, Witchcraft, That's Life, and Fly Me to the Moon. So we hope you enjoy Sinatra.
Thank you.
From the pop world of Sinatra, let's go a little classier. It's a chart written in 1949 by Leroy Anderson, especially for the Boston Pops Orchestra, then led by Arthur Fiedler. Anderson said he had never heard a soft piece for trumpet, so he composed one based on bugle notes and a quiet orchestra accompaniment intended to put babies asleep. So here is our own trumpet trio featured in Leroy Anderson's A Trumpeter's Lullaby. Now, let's swing back from the middle to the early decades of the 20th century, and a style of music made famous in the dives of New Orleans and in Chicago. It became a favorite all over the world, and we call it Dixieland. Still enjoyed at jazz festivals everywhere. While our Dixieland jazz cats are setting up, here's a bit of information about that style. In the early 1900s, many marching band, military bands, and church musicians also played at the nightclubs in the bars and saloons of Storyville, a district of New Orleans. providing musical entertainment, especially for the visiting sailors. The style of music developed by the Storyville bands is known as Dixieland, named after the group originally called the Original Dixieland Jazz Band, formed in 1916. The New Orleans style Dixieland usually featured a melody with variations played by trumpet and other instruments, which is the clarinet, trombone, saxophone, tuba, and sometimes piano or banjo, playing improvisations all at the same time, while the drum would keep the beat and add syncopations. The New Orleans style is exhibited in our next medley, featuring our Dixieland Jazz Cats playing Royal Garden Blues, 1919, Mississippi Mud, 1927, and Back Home in Indiana, 1917. Take it away, guys.
Thank you.
While the big band era, you all right?
That's okay.
Getting in the way here. Of course, the swinging style of that music became the musical signature of the 30s and 40s and 50s, and that was big band dance music. There were a great many leaders of that era, but the name that usually comes to mind first is Glenn Miller. Here's a review of some of his most popular charts: In the Mood, A String of Pearls, Tuxedo Junction, and Pennsylvania 65,000. And by the way, dancing in the aisles is strictly permitted.
Thank you.
While the big band era was enormously popular, not all music of the mid-20th century was swing. One big band leader teamed up with his brother to compose music for films and concert bands with a travelogue theme. Walt Leslie and his brother Kermit wrote Bermuda Holiday, Montana Roundup, and Enchanted Isle, among others. We hope you enjoy their music on your night flight to Madrid. Now come back to the America of the 1920s and let's go to Harlem, specifically the Cotton Club and Duke Ellington. As a composer, pianist, and leader of a jazz orchestra from 1923 for more than 50 years, he gained both a national following here in the States as well as fame in Europe through goodwill tours sponsored by the U.S. State Department. Here's a medley of great tunes that created all the buzz. Take the A-Train, Don't Get Around Much Anymore, Caravan, Mood Indigo. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. So here's Duke Ellington in concert.
Thank you.
Well, it's been our pleasure taking you back and forth in time to survey so many of the great styles of music that we've enjoyed. For our last stop, we need your help with a great march that was so very popular in New York's Central Park Bandstand in the 20s. It was written to be a crowd pleaser, and it involved audience participation. You get a chance to help us out. So, our first horn player, Nita Redmond, is going to help you with the words.
Okay, as Gene said, you have to help us out, so you have to help with the lyrics. Now, don't worry, I have the lyrics right here. So, that's your part, and I'll help you out, and you sing with me. Y'all got this? I'll put it down.
Thank you so, so very much. You've been an absolutely wonderful audience. I wanted to take special thanks for our band members who played the kazoos in that last one as well. I'm sorry, they were a little out of tune, but not bad. We want to give special thanks to Tom Keener, who manages this hall and these performances, for allowing us seniors to share our musical joy with you. Now, would you like to hear one more piece? Hey, wonderful. How about the march made famous in the 1957 movie, The Bridge and the River Kwai? William Holden, Alec Guinness, and Jack Hawkins. You know it. It's Colonel Bogey. Here it is.